Hey everyone, it's Hiro. It's summertime here in Japan, and honestly, it feels like it's getting hotter every year. So in today's video, I want to talk a bit about how Medaka handle high temperatures. If you are keeping your Medaka outdoors, I'm sure you have a question about how to deal with the summer heat. I hope this video will give you same helpful tips, especially if you are a fellow Medaka lover. On this channel, I, Hiro, an aquarist and a Medaka enthusiast from Japan, share videos all about Japan's unique fish. If you are into Medaka or Japanese aquariums in general, don't forget to hit that subscribe button. Let's jump right in. So, what the max temperature Medaka can tolerate? From my experience, assuming water quality is good, they can handle up to about 35 degrees Celsius surprisingly well. While Medaka in Japan naturally live in small ponds and rice fields, where the water is shallow and there are little flow. These spots are great for hiding from predators, but they also experience big temperature swings. In the summer, shallow rice paddies under direct sunlight can get really hot, even in nature. So Medaka are naturally pretty tough when it comes to high temperatures. That said, when the water hits 35 degrees Celsius or more, they start slowing down and will often hang out near the surface, gasping for air. For that reason, I treat 35 degrees Celsius as my upper limit when managing water temperature. But as I mentioned earlier, there are a few extra things to keep in mind when keeping them in tank or tub. Let's go over those. Have you ever noticed that during summer, your Medaka tub suddenly turns green? Especially in bare tanks, strong sunlight and high temps are the perfect lens for green water, algae bloom. Interestingly, green water tends to heat up more than clear water. I've tested this myself. Under the same conditions, green water often ends up being warmer. In nature, Medaka don't usually live in green water environments, so if your tub goes green, it's important to monitor the temperature carefully. To keep your water clear, you can add substrate, grow aquatic plants, or shade the tank to prevent excessive algae growth. Green water is great for raising fry if used correctly, but just remember, it heats up faster than clear water. Another super important thing to remember, water temperature affects ammonia toxicity. Leftover food and Medaka waste release ammonia, which is toxic to fish. And the hotter the water, the more dangerous ammonia becomes. Even small amounts of ammonia can cause poisoning and kill your Medaka. Normally, beneficial bacteria in your tank break down ammonia into harmless substances. But right after a full water change, these bacteria may not be present, and that's when the risk of ammonia poisoning is highest. On the flip side, green water actually absorbs ammonia, which is kind of amazing. So if your tank easily develops green water, a full water change is usually okay. For green water to thrive, you need water temperatures, sunlight, and ammonia. Yep. Ammonia is algae food. From my own experience, the color of the container also affects how quickly green water develops. White container turn green faster than black ones. Blue ones work too. In Japan, lots of Medaka keepers use bright colored tubs like these. Once you've got green water going, you can even use some of it as seed water for a newly changed tank. Honestly, if it's hot out, green water is going to form whether you want it or not. It's a great breeding technique, but if you want to enjoy a crystal water aquarium, green water probably isn't for you. In that case, try adding gravel, filters, air pumps, or plenty of plants to enjoy your medaka in clear water. Let's talk about a few risks with green water. Green water is full of living plankton, which means it can be tricky to manage. During the day, algae photosynthesize and release oxygen, great for medaka. But at night, they switch to respiration and actually consume oxygen. If the green water is too dense, or if you are keeping too many fish in it, you could run into oxygen shortages. To avoid this, do partial water changes now and then to keep the green water at the safe level. Also, watch out for rain. A heavy downpour can certainly cool the water or block sunlight. If sunlight disappears too quickly, the algae can die off all at once, turning the water brown and clear. This sudden change means all the ammonia they were keeping in check start to spike, and that's when medaka start getting sick. So yeah, green water takes some skill to manage. Because of this, some people prefer the stability of clear water with well-established bacteria. For the record, I've recently been keeping my medaka in clear water using aeration and filter. Lastly, let's talk about shading your medaka tubs in the summer. I use a traditional Japanese bamboo screen called a slate. It's perfect because it lets in a bit of light between the bamboo strips, so you don't end up with total darkness. Thanks to that, I can usually keep the water temperature around 32 to 33 degrees Celsius. You can also use household sunshades, but be careful not to block too much light. If it gets too dark, medaka may stop breeding. On the other hand, too much sunlight will overheat the water. An ideal spot would be somewhere that gets morning sun but turns it light shade in the afternoon. Also, keep in mind the size and color of your container. Small tubs heat up faster, so go for larger ones that hold more water if possible. I personally use black tubs for specific reasons, but if you are worried about temperature, lighter colored ones are safer. I've explained more about container selection in a previous video. Check it out if you're interested. So, what did you think? Are most of you keeping your medaka outdoors? If so, today's topic is especially important. I hope it helps you out. And don't forget to hit the like button if you found this helpful. Lately, I've been getting more and more comments and likes from you all. It makes me really happy. One day, I'd love to meet medaka fans around the world in person. Thanks so much for watching again today. I'll see you in the next video.